हेलो स्टूडेंट, टुडे आवर टॉपिक इज रैशनल एंड इरेशनल नंबर। सो फर्स्ट वी मेमोराइज प्रीवियस लेक्चर। रैशनल एंड इरेशनल नंबर वी ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड इन प्रीवियस क्लास। नाउ व्हाट इज रैशनल नंबर? सो यू नो दैट रैशनल नंबर व्हिच कैन बी रिटन इन द फॉर्म ऑफ फ्रैक्शन, दैट इज पी अपॉन क्यू, where pq are integer and q is not equal to 0. So we see that the fraction are either terminating decimal or non-terminating but repeating decimal. For example, we write in the p upon q form, that is 1 upon 2. So 1 upon 2, this is a rational number because this is in the form of p upon q, and we write this rational number into the fraction, so the value is 0.5, or we take 1 upon 4 is equal to 0.25. so after the certain decimal place the remainder is 0 in both rational number. So we can say that this is a terminating decimal. This type of the decimal number is terminating decimals. And when we take another rational number in the form of p upon q, consider 1 upon 3. So this will be 0.3, 3 threes are 9, 3 threes are 9. And then once again the remainder is 1, so 3 3 is a 9. So this will always repeating 3 3 3, this always repeating. So this type of the decimal is called non-terminating but repeating decimal. Non-terminating but repeating decimal. So it is clear that rational number has two type of the decimal numbers. First is terminating decimal and second is non-terminating but repeating decimal. So what is irrational number? We discuss about the irrational number also, but one time memorize. Irrational number which cannot be written in the form of p upon q means we cannot express in the form of fraction, and pq are integer and q is not equal to 0, and terminating rational number are terminating decimal. So irrational number are just opposite of the terminating, that is non-terminating, and rational number is repeating decimal. So irrational number is non-terminating and non-repeating. So we can say that rational number which cannot be expressed in the form of p upon q or this is irrational number can be expressed in the form of non-terminating and non-repeating decimal. So it is clear that irrational number are non-terminating and non-repeating decimal. Example 1.321573 and so on. So this is never end, means non-terminating, and any number is also not repeating. So this type of the decimal number are called non-terminating and non-repeating decimal. So we also know about the irrational number, that under root 2 is irrational number. Why? Because this is not perfect square. So we can say that square root of any non-perfect number, or we can say the square root of non-perfect square number, square root of non-perfect square number आर कॉल्ड द इरेशनल नंबर. एग्जाम्पल अंडर रूट 3, अंडर रूट 4. सो अंडर रूट 4 इज परफेक्ट स्क्वायर. सो अंडर रूट 4 मीन्स 2. सो 2 अपॉन 1, दैट इज अंडर रूट 4 इज इक्वल टू 2 अपॉन 1. सो दिस इज रेशनल नंबर. सो अंडर रूट 5, अंडर रूट 6, अंडर रूट 7 एंड सो ऑन. सो ऑल द नॉन परफेक्ट स्क्वायर नंबर आर कॉल्ड द इरेशनल नंबर. एंड नॉन परफेक्ट क्यूब विच नंबर हैव नॉट परफेक्ट क्यूब. फॉर एग्जाम्पल नॉन परफेक्ट क्यूब नंबर्स, नॉन परफेक्ट क्यूब नंबर्स. एग्जाम्पल क्यूब रूट ऑफ 2, क्यूब रूट ऑफ 4, क्यूब रूट ऑफ 5, क्यूब रूट ऑफ 6, क्यूब रूट ऑफ 7. सो दीज आर कॉल्ड द नॉन परफेक्ट क्यूब एंड दिस टाइप ऑफ क्यूब इरेशनल नंबर. इफ वी टेक क्यूब रूट ऑफ 8, क्यूब रूट ऑफ 8. सो क्यूब रूट ऑफ 8 मीन्स 2 into 2 into 2. So this is perfect cube. The value is 2. So cube root of 8 is rational number because 8 is perfect cube. So we can say that 2 is rational number, not irrational number. So cube root of 8 is rational number. So what is the irrational number? Which the number which is in the square root and which is not a perfect square, nor which is not a perfect cube, that is called the irrational number. Now we represent the irrational number between the two irrational number. Consider two irrational number are root 4, square root of 2 and square root of 7, and represent two irrational number between root 2 and root 7. So first of all we square this. Root 2 square is 2 and root 7 square is 7. So between the 2 and 7 there is 3, 4, 5, 6. So there are so many numbers between the 2 and 7. So we write in square root. Now root 7 and root 2 and root 7. We represent the irrational number between root 2 and root 7. So if we take the square root of 4, it will be rational number. So we leave that, and root 3, root 5, root 7, root 6. So these three numbers are irrational number between the two irrational number. So irrational number between the root 2 and root 7, that is root 3, root 5 and root 6. Now we see the different properties of the irrational number. So properties of the irrational number satisfy the commutative property, associative property and distributive property for the addition and multiplication. So this property, commutative property, associative and distributive property, these property applicable for the addition and multiplication. Now second one, sum of two irrational number need not be an irrational. It means when we add the two irrational number, so it is not necessary that the sum of two irrational number is irrational number. For example, here 2 plus root 7, when we add 2 plus root 7, this is irrational number, because when we add non-terminating and non-repeating decimal with 2, so it will be also a irrational number. एंड रूट थ्री, सॉरी थ्री प्लस थ्री माइनस रूट सेवन. व्हेन वी एड दिस बोथ इरेशनल नंबर, सो इट इज नॉट नेसेसरी टू प्लस रूट सेवन प्लस थ्री माइनस रूट सेवन. सो माइनस रूट सेवन प्लस रूट सेवन, दिस विल बी कैंसिल एंड टू प्लस थ्री इज इक्वल टू फाइव, विच इज रेशनल नंबर. सो सम ऑफ टू इरेशनल नंबर नीड नॉट बी एन इरेशनल नंबर, बिकॉज व्हेन वी एडिंग टू इरेशनल नंबर, सो इट इज नॉट नेसेसरी दैट इट विल बी irrational number, it may be rational number. Similarly, difference of two irrational number need not be an irrational. For example, 4 plus root 3, we subtract 2 plus root 3. So when we subtract two irrational number, so it is also not necessary that the difference of the two irrational number will be irrational number. 4 plus root 3 minus 2 minus plus into minus, that is minus. When we multiply negative number and open the bracket, so all sign will be changed. Plus 2 will be minus 2 and this plus root 3 will be minus root 3. So now plus root 3 minus root 3, this will be cancelled and 4 minus 2 will be 2. So 2 is irrational number, where the 2 irrational, when we find their difference, so it will be a rational number. So difference of 2 irrational numbers need not be an irrational. Now product of 2 irrational number need not be an irrational. So product of two irrational number need not be an irrational. When we multiply the two irrational number, it is not necessary that the product will be also a irrational number. For example, under root 3 into under root 3, both are irrational number. When we multiply, so the result will be 3. So this will be rational number, and when we multiply two irrational number, then the result may be a rational number. Next, quotient of two irrational number need not be an irrational number, means when we divide the two irrational number, so it is not necessary that their quotient will be also a irrational number. For example, square root of 6 upon square root of 3. So both are irrational number. When we divide each other, so it will be root 6 upon 3, and which is equal to root 2. So it will be irrational number when we divide. But it is not necessary that always when we divide two irrational number, the result will be irrational number. For example, 3 root 2 divided by root 2. So this is irrational number, 3 root 2, and root 2 will be also a irrational number. So when we dividing irrational by irrational, so root 2, root 2 will be cancelled and result will be 3. So this is rational number. So it is not necessary that always when we divide the irrational number divided by irrational number, so it always be a irrational number. It may be a rational number also. Next, second properties of the irrational number, this is third property, that sum of rational and irrational number is irrational. For example, 3 plus root 2, so both are, one is irrational and one is rational number. So when we add the rational number and irrational number, then result will be also irrational number. Rational plus irrational is always irrational number. Next, difference of a rational and an irrational is irrational. So 3 minus root 3 or 3 minus root 5 is always irrational. This is also irrational number. Product of a rational and an irrational is irrational. When we multiply 3 into root 3, then the result will be 3 root 3, which is irrational. एंड क्वाइसेंट ऑफ अ रेशनल एंड एन इरेशनल नंबर इज इरेशनल. इट मीन्स व्हेन वी डिवाइड अ रेशनल नंबर बाय द इरेशनल नंबर, फॉर एग्जांपल 5 डिवाइड बाय रूट 3, सो द रिजल्ट इज इरेशनल नंबर. ओके, सो हेयर वन क्वेश्चन, प्रूव दैट रूट 5 इज इरेशनल नंबर. वी हैव टू प्रूव दैट रूट 5 इज इरेशनल नंबर. सो इन फर्स्ट स्टेप वी सपोज दैट रूट 5 इज रेशनल नंबर. इफ पॉसिबल देन इट सेटिस्फाई द ऑल कंडीशन ऑफ द रेशनल नंबर, अदरवाइज इट विल बी इरेशनल नंबर. सो इन फर्स्ट स्टेप इफ पॉसिबल देन वी एज्यूम दैट रूट 5 इज रेशनल नंबर. लेट इट्स सिंपलेस्ट फॉर्म, सिंपलेस्ट फॉर्म मीन्स रेशनल नंबर इज सेट टू बी इन सिंपलेस्ट फॉर्म इफ द p and q both are co-prime number. Co-prime number means p and q have no common factor other than 1. So here let its simplest form be root 5 is equal to p upon q, because we suppose here root 5 is rational. If root 5 is rational, then it can be written in the form of p upon, we can write here in the form of p upon q. So the condition is that p and q are integer and p q having the no common factor other than 1 and q is also not equal to 0. It means the root 5 can be expressed in the form of p upon q, and p q is in simplest form like as 3 upon 4. So in 3 upon 4 both are divisible by only one number, that is 1. So 3 and 4 is called the co-prime number. 3 and 4 called the co-prime means there is no common factor. This is already in simplest form. So p upon q is also in simplest form. So squaring equation first we get. So first of all, we assume any irrational number as a rational number and squaring both sides. So squaring both sides, root 5 whole square, the value is root 5 whole square is equal to 5, and p by q whole square is equal to p square upon q square. Equation first we squaring both sides, and then by the cross multiplication 5 into q square, that is 5 q square is equal to p square. So after the squaring we cross multiply, 5 q square is equal to p square. So it so that, for example, if 20 is equal to 5 into 4, so we can say that 5 is factor of 20 as well as 4 is also a factor of 20. So here 5 q square is equal to p square. It so that p square is multiple of 5. P square is multiple of 5. So conversely we can say that 5 is factor of p square. If any number is multiple of 5, if any number consider 25 is multiple of 5, so we can say that 5 is factor of 25. So here if p square is multiple of 5, because p square is equal to 5 into something, it means p square is multiple of 5, so 5 is factor of p square. So 5 is factor of p also. If 5 is factor of 25, then 5 is factor of 5 square. So simply 5 is a factor of 5 also. And first supposition that root 5 is equal to p upon q, then we get 5 is factor of p. Next, if p is factor of 5, it means p is multiple of 5 or 5 is factor of p, then for some positive integer we put p is equal to 5m. We put this value p is equal to 5m. So if p is equal to 5m, in equation second we get इन इक्वेशन सेकंड वी पुट द वैल्यू ऑफ p इज इक्वल टू 5m, सो 5q² सेम हियर एंड p² मींस द वैल्यू ऑफ p इज 5m. वी सपोज हियर p इज इक्वल टू 5m, सो वी पुट 5m होल स्क्वायर. व्हाट इज द वैल्यू? 5q² इज इक्वल टू p² मीन्स 5m होल स्क्वायर, दैट इज 25m². सो हियर q² इज इक्वल टू 5 इज मल्टीप्लाई विथ q² वी व्हेन ब्रिंगिंग फ्रॉम ट्रांसपोजिंग फ्रॉम वन साइड टू अदर साइड, सो q² इज इक्वल टू 25/5, दैट इज 5m². So q² is equal to 5m². Here also it is clear that q² is equal to 5 into m². It means q² is multiple of 5. q² is multiple of 5. That is 5 is factor of q². If any number is factor of their square, consider 3 is a factor of 6² 3 is means 6² is divisible by 3, then 6 is also divisible by 3. So if 5 is factor of q², then 5 is factor of q also. So here it is clear from here and here that 5 is factor of p and here 5 is factor of q. So 5 is factor of p and q. So this contradicts, means this not satisfy whatever we suppose. Here we assume that p and q are integer and p q having no common factor. There is no common factor of p and q other than 1. And here we find that 5 is factor of p and q. 5 is factor of p and q. So which contradicts, not matching. So that p and q have no common factor other than 1. Our supposition was this, and here the conclusion we getting 5 is factor of p and q. So our supposition is wrong. Whatever we suppose, that is wrong. So we can say that root 5 is not rational number, it is irrational number. Rationalize the denominator. If any irrational number is given, consider 1/√3. So the denominator is irrational number and numerator 1 is rational number, because 1 is rational number. So we rationalize the denominator, we make the denominator as a rational number. So by which number we multiply, then we get the rational number as a denominator. So here √3. So √3 we multiply by the √3, because when we multiply the square root of the same number, the product of the square root of the same number, then we get the whole number. Consider this is the definition of square root also, that when we square any square root number, then we get the same number, means square root of any number and their square is always the same number. So here √3 into 1, that is √3/√3, that is 3. So √3/3 is same as 1/√3, but here denominator is rational number, means we rationalize the denominator. Similarly here also √3/√2/√3-√2, we rationalize the denominator, means numerator and denominator, there are two component in the fraction, so we rationalize the denominator. So first solution, √3/√2/√3-√2, this is our number and we rationalize this. So rationalize the denominator. Denominator is √3/√2. By which number we multiply in numerator and denominator, then this denominator will rationalize. So listen, this is √3/√2. So the conjugate, we take always conjugate of that number, means if any number is a plus b, we take a minus b, because the formula of a plus b and a minus b is a² - b². So here also we multiply by the same conjugate of denominator, because we want to rationalize the denominator. So what is the conjugate of root 3 minus root 2? Root 3 minus root 2, here the conjugate of a plus b is a minus b. So we multiply root 3 plus root 2 in numerator as well as in denominator. So here, when we multiply two fraction, so numerator multiply in numerator and denominator multiply in denominator. Here root 3 plus root 2, root 3 plus root 2, both are same number. Then we square root 3 plus root 2 whole square, because this is and this both is same. So a plus b into a plus b, that is a plus b whole square, and this is a minus b and this is a plus b and a minus b. The result is a square minus b square. We multiply by the same number. So a square root 3 whole square minus root 2, a minus b, a plus b, a square minus b square, root 2 whole square. So the value is a plus b whole square, a square plus b square plus 2ab. So here root 3 square plus root 2 square plus 2 into root 3 into root 2 upon, this is a square minus b square. The square of root 3 means root 3 into root 3, that is root 9. So value is 3. When we square any square root number, so it will be whole, square root will be removed. So root 2 whole square, that is 2. Root 3 square, 3 plus 2 plus 2, root a into root b is equal to root ab. We multiply, but root a plus root b, we cannot add root a plus b. This is property of the surds. Surds means under root. This is property of the surd, that if we multiply two surds, then we write together a into b. And here in case of the addition, we cannot write root a plus root b is not equal to root a plus b. So here denominator is 3 minus 2, 1, and this is root 3 into root 2, that is root 6. 3, 2, 5, both are like numbers, and plus root 6 upon 1. So here denominator is 1, so we can say that this is in rationalization form. We rationalize the denominator. We no need to write the denominator, so here only the answer is 5 plus 2 root 6. Similarly, here simplify this also. So root 3 plus root 2 upon root 3 minus root 2. This and this both are same. This and this. Only you have to rationalize this. Root 3 minus root 2 upon root 3 plus root 2. So similarly, you rationalize this also, and then the value of this is 5 plus 2 root 6. And when you rationalize this, so you will get this is 3 minus 2, that is 1, and directly I am solving root 3 plus root 2. We multiply by the root 3 minus root 2 upon root 3 minus root 2. Then this is a plus b, a minus b, then value will be 1, 3 square minus 2 square, root 3 square, that is 3, minus root 2 square is 2. And here we multiply root 3 minus root 2 and root 3 minus root 2. So a minus b whole square, that is root 3 square plus root 2 square minus 2 root 3 into root 2, that is 2 root 6. So here 3 minus 2 is 1, and we add 5 plus 2 root 6 plus 3 to 5 minus 2 root 6. So plus root 6 and minus root 2 root 6, both will be cancelled, and 5 plus 5, the result is 10. So you try to solve this also. And in question number 3, in this question, इफ ए एंड बी आर रेशनल नंबर्स, इफ ए एंड बी आर रेशनल नंबर एंड द वैल्यू इज गिवन 2+√3/2-√3 इज इक्वल टू a+b√3, देन फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ ए एंड बी. सो वी ऑल्सो रेशनलाइज दिस 2+√3 2+√3/2-√3 इज इक्वल टू a+b√3. दिस इज गिवेन एंड वी हैव टू फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ ए एंड बी. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी रेशनलाइज दिस एंड राइट इन द फॉर्म ऑफ a+b√3 इन दिस फॉर्म एंड कंपेयर द कोफिशियंट ऑफ √3 इज इक्वल टू b एंड द a दैट इज रेशनल नंबर विल बी that is value of a because it is given a and b are rational number. So rationalize the denominator, rationalize denominator. So we multiply the conjugate of this number 2+√3/2-√3. So the what is the conjugate rationalizing factor of 2-√3? The conjugate 2-√3, the conjugate will be 2+√3, and we multiply numerator and denominator by the same rationalizing factor, which is equal to a+b√3 given. So when we rationalize a 2+√3 into 2+√3, the value is 2+√3 whole square/a-b and a+b that is 2√3 whole square because this is 2 and 2 and second term √3 and √3. So first term and second term respective terms are equal, then we square first term minus square of second term, which is equal to a+b√3. So the value of a+b whole square, a square plus b square plus 2 into a, 2 into a is 2 and b is √3 upon a square means 4-√3 whole square. So square root will be removed, 4-3, which is equal to a+b√3. Once again we square 2 square is 4, √3 square is 3 plus 2 to the 4 √3 means upon 4-3 is equal to 1, which is equal to a+b√3. Here the like term that is 4 and 3, because in this term there is no attach any under root, so 4 and 3 we add, that is 7+4√3, which is equal to a+b√3. So what is the value of a? 7, and the coefficient which is multiply with √3, that is b is multiply with 3. So coefficient of √3 is b, so here the coefficient of √3 is 4. So comparing both sides, a is equal to 7 and the what is the value of b, the coefficient of √3, that is 4, then b is equal to 4. This is answer, means the value of a is 7 and the value of b is equal to 4. So any number which is irrational number and the denominator, first of all we rationalize. So try to solve this question. If x is equal to 3+√8, find the value of x² + 1/x. So the value of x is given and then find the value of 1/x, means 1/3+√8, and then the rationalizing factor multiply. What is the rationalizing factor of the denominator? 3+√8. So 3-√8 here. 3-√8. Rationalizing factor will be conjugate of that number, means if a+b is there, so we write a-b. Similarly, simplify this and then find the value of x. Okay, so in last question, question number 5, so that वन अपान थ्री माइनस रूट एट माइनस वन अपान रूट एट माइनस रूट सेवन प्लस वन अपान रूट सेवन माइनस रूट सिक्स माइनस वन अपान रूट सिक्स माइनस रूट फाइव प्लस वन अपान रूट फाइव माइनस टू इज इक्वल टू फाइव. मीन्स विद द हेल्प ऑफ लेफ्ट हैंड साइड वी प्रूव दैट द वैल्यू ऑफ दीज नंबर्स इज फाइव. सो हाउ विल यू सॉल्व? देयर आर वन टू थ्री फोर एंड फाइव, फाइव टर्म. सो ईच टर्म वी रेशनलाइज लाइक एज वन अपान थ्री माइनस रूट एट. सो व्हाट इज द रेशनलाइजिंग फैक्टर ऑफ दिस डिनोमिनेटर? थ्री प्लस रूट एट अपान थ्री प्लस रूट एट. इन बोथ न्यूमरेटर एंड डिनोमिनेटर वी मल्टीप्लाई द कॉन्जुगेट ऑफ दिस नंबर. मीन्स रेशनलाइजिंग फैक्टर ऑफ दिस नंबर इज थ्री प्लस रूट एट एंड देन simplify first term, similarly simplify all term, and when we add all the term together then result will be 5. So you solve question number 2 and 4 and 5 yourself. Thank you.